Talk 101 FM, first with news and talk in Decatur. I'm Tara Nickerson. You're listening to The Daily Wrap. Thanks for joining me. Well, it is Friday, and that means Friday's with Geno. Geno from The Real Opinion on WAND-TV is in the studio with me. Hi, Geno. How are you?
How's it going?
We want to talk about the movies that opened up last week. You got an opportunity to go and check those out. And for many of our listeners who haven't seen them yet, let's tell them whether it's worth the money or not.
Well, I've got a good couple recommendations. The first one that came out is Disney's Frozen, and I was wondering myself how this one was going to go. And what this one actually does is it's actually kind of a throwback to the classic Disney princesses, and it's just kind of the new era of them, because it's now they're not doing a lot of hand-drawn stuff, it's in CG. And I have to say, it's for a lot of reasons a lot of fun, and it's very funny. It was way better than I thought it was going to be. The previews didn't really draw me in, but you know, like I said, it just kind of, it's a nice throwback. You have the things like Love at First Sight and people breaking out in the song.
Mm-hmm.
But not only do they do that, they also kind of make fun of it.
Yeah.
So it's kind of self-aware. The characters sing songs that they... it's making fun of themselves, yet they don't know they're making fun of themselves, and it's a lot of fun. There's also some serious elements to it too, and it's just a lot of fun, and I really enjoyed it. The kids there were having fun. I was laughing. Most of the songs are good, but mostly it's fun and funny. Highly recommended by me.
Fantastic. That might be a great one for parents to take the kids to as they're looking for things to do this month. Let's talk about the other one, The Book Thief.
Yeah, The Book Thief. I got a chance to finally check it out, and it's one of the best movies of the year. I'm not going to call it best movie of the year because I still have to mull over a lot of that, but it's kind of hard to watch because of some of the imagery you get. The biggest flaw of the movie was they don't really show the true cruelty that was the Nazis. You only get bits and pieces of it.
Mm-hmm.
And for those that don't know what it's about a little girl growing up in Nazi Germany, and she's goes to live with foster parents. And she, over time, learns what the Nazis stand for, and she kind of stands up to them in her own way. And really, the hard parts to watch is you get to see the beginning of brainwashing in schools that the Nazis were pulling off. And the kids sing this song about Adolf Hitler, and it's watching them do it and watching them do the Sieg Heil and all that stuff is just really, I mean, it kicks you right in the gut.
Mm-hmm.
And it's real hard to watch. It had a great cast. Nobody really stood out, but the whole cast together made for just... they just handled the story well, and especially the children in the movie. The children held their own against the adult actors, and
wow,
you don't get to see that a lot. And I like I said, one of the best of the year, and it you never know, I may call it best of the year.
Sounds fantastic. A good one to go and check out, especially if you like impactful films, for sure. Let's talk about what's going to be opening up in theaters this weekend.
First one is Christian Bale's new movie, Out of the Furnace. And it's Out of the Furnace. It's one I've been waiting for about a year now when I heard about it. And once the trailer came out, I was ready for it. And it's about a guy that... he gets out of prison, and he finds out his brother is doing underground fighting, and his brother refuses to throw a fight, and then he disappears. And then it's about a man, the law won't help him, it's about a man taking action to his own hands and going into basically the lion's den of a place where the police won't go, and he goes to find his brother. And it's got Woody Harrelson in it, who's kind of the leader of the bad guys. I'm really looking forward to that, because when he plays crazy and bad, it's usually pretty good, like Natural Born Killers. It's just one, I want to see it. It's got a great cast. Like I said, Forrest Whitaker's in it, Sam Shepard, Willem Dafoe, many others. And it just looks like one of those that you hope that they bring a cast like this together, that they deliver. Unfortunately, it doesn't happen all the time, but when it does, it's awesome.
Well, it might be a fantastic one to check out this weekend. And what else have we got opening up?
Well, last week, at very limited theaters, there's a movie called Old Boy and it was made in Korea in 2003. I actually watched it a couple weeks ago, and it's one of those movies that will really mess with your mind. And I watched it, and it does it to you a few times. And I'm really surprised they have a remake, but Spike Lee has directed a remake of it. And what it is a man is taken hostage, and you don't know why. And in the original, he's held in a hotel room for 15 years. In the new one, it's 20 years. Josh Brolin is going to be the guy that's being held. And he's given the same meal every day. They knock him out with gas and give him haircuts. And he's stuck in this room. He basically has a TV and a bed.
Wow.
And then, after 20 years, for no reason whatsoever, he's released. And then he finds out he has 5 days to find out who captured or who took him captive and why, or someone close to him is going to die.
And, wow.
And it's, and I tell you, watching the original, I wonder why they're remaking it, but I'm really hoping it stands up to the original because the original is fantastic.
Wow. So this is definitely, that would be a heavy one. Like you said, maybe mess with your mind a little bit.
The movie is extremely brutal and violent.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very, like I said, the twists and turns that it gives you will make you shake your head. And I still shake my head thinking about it. And I don't know if they're going to go as far as the Korean version did, because it went pretty far in the twisted, you know, the twisted nature of it.
Yeah.
But for anyone that likes action scenes that take like maybe two or three shots to do, where they follow the action, the original has a scene, let's just say it involves one man versus 20 and a hammer.
Wow.
And it's hard. I don't even want to give it away. It's just a lot of fun to watch for action fans. And if you can stand the twists and turns, the original is an excellent movie. I'm hoping the new one's just as good.
And so the title of that one again?
Old Boy.
Old Boy. So,
and if you watch the movie, the title will make sense. It doesn't make sense till you watch the movie.
All right. And so I know we have some movie news headlines we want to get to as well. One, you know, particularly sad and tragic news headline.
Yeah. Paul Walker died in a car crash coming. I believe he was leaving a charity event.
Mm-hmm.
The details are still pretty slim. They said speed was a factor. All the details aren't out. He wasn't driving the car. The car had something to do with the charity. He was a race car driver, and of course, he's in the Fast and Furious movies and stuff like that. It's going to be a big loss. The big news is they have stopped filming of that, and of course, because they're trying to figure out how they want to proceed. They're either going to stop and remake the whole thing and write out his character, find a way to write him out in the movie, which I hope they don't do, because it'd be kind of odd, because
yeah,
you know, you can't film the scenes with the guy, and everyone will know it's a stunt double.
Right.
I'd rather see him just write him out, maybe say he, since his character had a kid in the last one, you know, write him out and he lives happily ever after and let the others move on. Or you could just recast the part.
Right.
It wouldn't be the first time. When the actor that played Dumbledore died after, I believe it was the second or third Harry Potter movie, they had to recast the part.
Yeah.
You know, and they did. And fans say it worked just fine. So if you have to recast, I think it'd be respectful to him. I don't think it's disrespecting him at all to recast the part.
Yeah. Well, it'll be interesting to see what they do there. But I know big-time Paul Walker fans were very sad to hear of his passing. And, you know, it's one of those things. You hate to hear news headlines like that. But sometimes I think, too, in the media, we put too much emphasis on the deaths of famous people.
Right.
When, you know, there are other people who are dying all the time. And it doesn't get any mention. But I know his fans were very saddened by that. Let's talk about another news item you've got.
Yeah, Quentin Tarantino went on a talk show the other day, and he talked about what his next movie is going to be. He's not giving much details because, well, that's Quentin Tarantino. But he said he's doing another Western, and before everyone gets excited, no, it's not a sequel to Django. Everyone thought, oh, we could continue the adventures of Django, being that the inspiration for Django was a series of movies, and
mm-hmm.
everyone thought, oh, we're going to see more Jamie Foxx's Django, which I named that my favorite movie of last year. I was excited.
Yeah.
But then he said, no, it's not going to be a sequel to Django. So that's unfortunate. However, if you read up on Tarantino's movies, all of his movies connect in some way, shape, or form. Either there's relatives, like one of the guys from Reservoir Dogs is related to one of the guys in Pulp Fiction and vice
mm-hmm.
versa. And they all come together in some way, shape, or form. So you never know, there might be a connection to Django or any of his other movies. You just never know.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what he's going to do, but we do know it's going to be Western.
Right.
All right. Well, fantastic. Thanks for bringing us the reviews and the movie news. We do appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
All right. This has been Fridays with Geno. I'm Tara Nickerson. You're listening to The Daily Wrap. This is Talk 101 FM. And remember, you can always go online to Facebook. It's The Real Geno, right?
That's right.
R-E-E-L. This is Talk 101 FM. We're always first with news and talk indicators. Later.